Now from a field that will host Super Bowl 58 come February, there's a good look inside Allegiant Stadium just off the 15 here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Today we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Aviators of Paris taking on the Las Vegas Raiders. Set to go now in week six of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now Garoppolo. Oh, the first play of the game going to be intercepted. Picked off by Christian Gonzalez. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line.
Wow, just one snap in, partner, and the complexion of this game has already changed, because for the defensive side, they just handed their offense a short field and a big early advantage. And even though it's only the first snap of the game, we're going to look back on this one and see if it has lasting effects as this game moves on.
And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. 11 yards for number 11.
If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose runner pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play.
Elliott going to get it again on 2nd down. And it'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Definitely be a disappointment to come out of this starting position with just 3 points. They need to try to dial something up now, 3rd and 10. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? 3rd and short, they elect to throw for it. And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on 3rd and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there.
And his kick here is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Vegas offense ready to start this next drive.
Their 2nd drive here, the ballgame, Charles. Remember last time they threw the interception, but the defense held up. It bent a little but didn't break, only giving up the 3 points.
Yeah, obviously they left some points on the table there their last time out, but boy, they have to thank their defense for holding the opposition just 3 after they threw the pick. Their turn now. Back out on the field, put together a good drive, and get some points of their own.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
That burst good for 20 and a first down. Pretty explosive run on that inside handoff, and when you're a runner of his caliber, you don't need a big crease.
You really don't, but also what we're seeing is an offensive line that's taking charge at the point of attack, aren't we? Not only are they controlling the initial contact, they're actually utilizing what they call the strain the next 2 to 3 seconds to continue to move people.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. The Raiders at 2-3 here to begin the new season. And they come in losers of 2 straight, so trying to turn things around here.
And you just mentioned 2 straight, and when you're talking about 2 games, that's nothing to panic about. They feel like they've been a little bit unlucky in the last couple. This is a club that's more than capable of turning things around, and I expect them to play really well here.
To throw is Garoppolo. Got a man, it's Mayer. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5.
11.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. So no gain on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and goal.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
Here we go.
Once again, the 5 as they get ready for 2nd and goal.
21. Here we go.
Now they'll put a receiver in motion left.
On
2nd down, Jacobs. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now 3rd down coming up.
Now that was a terrific play. We're down here near the goal line, and only one word comes to mind for me, and that's overwhelm. Because they absolutely overwhelmed the offensive line. He came free and made the hit in the backfield.
Here we go. Big play
forthcoming. Here's 3rd and goal.
1, Omaha.
They'll run with Jacobs. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up 4th.
So off is Garoppolo, and in comes Daniel Carlson for the Raider field goal.
From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. Carlson able to put this one through, and that will tie us at 3-3. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. A first down carry by Elliott. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
You look at this Raiders defense.
They're in the spot statistically that you don't want to be in against the pass. Number 32 in the league, dead last.
That was a nice play right there, but overall this season, it's been an absolute disaster. A total lack of communication on the back end. They need a leader who can put this team, this unit.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
Here we go.
So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. A nice little screen. They get 6 on 1st down.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored him, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by Adrian Phillips. Down to the 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think they, were they a nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did and came through with a big-time pick six.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. 10-3 our score after one here on EA Sports. Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football. As they've got it as we resume action. Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. Here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And they are a game under 500 now following the loss a week ago. And this is a team, Charles, that just has not been able to string victories together.
Yeah, they're certainly going the wrong way, aren't they? Because it looked like they had things pointing the right direction, but now they've lost two straight. And that means this game is vital, extremely important, because if they fall two games below 500, the road back into playoff contention, awfully difficult.
Here we go.
Second and 10. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line.
21.
That's good. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just so quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
A first run for the backup, Abdullah. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 5, and that leaves him with 5 more. 3rd and 5 now.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
I got this. 21. White. Hey, gun. 11.
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Over the middle, complete. That's Jacobs. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it 4th and inches.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be 4th and short.
Here we go.
So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. 4th down. Down the sideline he goes. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Josh Jacobs. His 5th rushing touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And we are even at 10 apiece. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. No run back here for Jones, a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They had the interception on the last drive, which led to the tying touchdown. So 10-10 the score as they begin first and 10. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run. Run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 11 yards for number 11.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Up the middle, here's Elliott. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Here we go, 11-11.
On second down, Elliott once more. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Now Jones. He's going to loft one deep left side here. This is caught inside the 15. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Well, make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers.
Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football, but it looks like one of the DBs has it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
We have seen this before. And we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Here we go.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
On first down, they go with Jacobs again. And the stiff arm made it a pretty little run, not a huge gain. But a nice chunk of yardage.
112 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Here we go.
Second down and four.
Once again, it's Jacobs. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. As they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half.
Here we go,
so
here we go.
Here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Black.
Now they'll throw with Garoppolo sliding out of the pocket. That one complete to Trey Tucker. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
65.
Play action. Garoppolo. Now he steps away. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Then their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Meanwhile, Garoppolo's throw into the hands of Hooper. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
Now whistles here, and I believe one of the Raider linemen might have been moving. Colton Miller, former first-round pick, called for the penalty there. A false start backs him up 5, first and 15. On play action, it's Garoppolo. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Marcus Jones picks it. Marcus Jones, a return man. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And this will come out to the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Throwing, Jones. Downfield and caught by Thornton. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. And a huge play that time. 49 yards.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
And he's going to be close to a first down as he gets this to the Raider 16. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
10th carry now for Elliott. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards.
just about got him into the end zone.
On third down, Elliott. And Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. Operating from the gun, Jones. And it's caught. Touchdown. Tyquan Thornton. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Aviators have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And that makes it a 17-10 score. So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end. Now a hit and a loose football. And I believe he was able to get this back. He was. Boy, after giving up the touchdown, lucky that didn't turn into another.
I didn't do this in college, but I did it in high school. When you return kicks,
here we go.
And you lose it yourself, the panic that goes through you and the determination to get the ball back.
21.
I don't even know how to describe it. You know, I think we just saw an example there.
Yeah, and the relief when you get it back like he did.
Yeah, you go to the sidelines, you know you're going to get yelled at, but you can handle it because you got the ball back.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. It's Marte Mapu, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together?
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And it's caught. Touchdown. Isaiah Hodgins, his first touchdown on the year. And the Aviators are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Back out is the kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive.
65.
And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership.
Here we go,
From the 29, here's second down at 7. Garoppolo looks to throw. And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. It's Marte Mapu. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage. Turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Here we go.
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
They will run the draw with Jacobs. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there.
139 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Garoppolo going to try and throw on third. He finds his man complete. It's Jacobs. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first down, Garoppolo. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Give him a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
Here we go. Go ahead.
Throw left side complete. That's Carter. So just 3 yards on the completion there, and it'll be second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7.
11.
Here's Garoppolo to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And the Raiders are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
13.
Here's Jacobs. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up 2nd and goal. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the 3rd quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The line of scrimmage, once again, the 5, as they get ready for 2nd and goal. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. He'll get an opportunity with it on the touch pass. And the Raiders are in for 6. Touchdown. Devontae Adams. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Raiders have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. No run back here for Jones, a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. This game was really a tussle, seemed like just a moment ago, and now they've got the momentum. A couple of scores on their last pair of drives.
And a two-score lead. I think here now you go conservative, right? Run the football, work the clock.
You know, I usually agree with you, but I'm going after them right here.
Really?
Put this bad boy away. I wouldn't be afraid to throw it. They've got all the confidence, all the momentum on their side. Go ahead and take your dagger shots and try and finish this one off.
I disagree vehemently. I say, run the football. You've got the lead.
Well, let's watch it and find out who's right.
Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
And on now is the punter. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. It's taken to the 26. A nice return that time. Gets 12 yards back. And the Raiders will take over now, first and 10. You don't see that too often, Charles. He punted that away and then hustled up to make the stop as well.
Yeah, because oftentimes they serve as their own safety after punting it. You want to be the last guy, but he decided to get involved in the action, didn't he? And what a spark that's got to provide for the rest of his team when they see their punter out there making a nice hit.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. Fourth quarter, every drive's so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You've got the first one for the second one to even matter.
They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. Flush to his right. It's caught inside the 25. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
Here we go.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Here we go.
Now a second and 10. Now a play fake. Garoppolo. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances.
Here we go,
they've
got to
put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
I got you. Hey, alert! 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 12!
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. The left side throw complete to Adams. And he is stopped just short on third down. Got 9 yards, but needed 10.
A 9-yard gain on the play. It's now fourth down.
They go with Jacobs. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Now a toss to the left for Jacobs. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Josh Jacobs with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Raiders have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. On is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And the fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
Well.
From the 29, Jones.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. And this offense on third down today, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. Jones. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he gets this to Thornton. Touchdown! Tyquan Thornton, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Aviators might be moving closer to an elusive second win of the year as they extend that fourth quarter lead. Now Ryland for the PAT. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Now Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. Here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. They'll come up 1st and 10 here. Garoppolo going to change the look here. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Now Garoppolo is in trouble, and down he goes. A big play needed, no doubt. 3rd and long. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. He's got a man, complete. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Just a difficult situation to be in here in the final minute. Down two scores, you know you need some providence from somewhere. They're going to keep firing away till the end, but this one falls incomplete.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers, and he will bring this all the way up to the 30-yard line.
With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys have been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it, it's not always how you start.
Ezekiel Elliott gonna take it the distance. He may go. And touchdown! Ezekiel Elliott, 70 yards.
And the Aviators look like they're about to put an end to their two-game losing streak as they add on to their lead. Extra point by Ryland, up and good.
And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21.
Raiders 24. Chad Ryland to kick off.
So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat.
And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts.
Here we go.
Will stop with 18 seconds remaining.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
Garoppolo's throw pulled in by Renfro. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Garoppolo on first down. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. And now with 6 seconds remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. On play action, now Garoppolo toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
White.
One final try now for Garoppolo. And this is dropped and incomplete. Well, there's a metaphor for how this one is gone as time has run out on this ball game.